where in large scale sickness or pandemic, but the behavior of the people has changed. The rich left the population centers for the rich country streets, but the towns, they did not waste it. They tended it to the sick, often at their own peril. My ministry is nursing homes, but don't call them that, because they'll come after your pains. They'd like to be called assisted. In the 10 years I've been doing, I've been handled with time to come and turn away because of sickness and homes. But the next week, everything will be fine. Not this week. My wife was attending to her mother in the hospital, and every day she'd stay with her for a few hours. When she was told that she was going to go to rehab, she'd pick up all her pretty clothes and bring home and have them clean. We heard that the home was based on the business, so she called to see her mother and her brother, and she visited. They said yes, an hour later we got a call. Home stopped all visits the next day, and she should come to her bed. She threw the clean clothes into a bag and ran over. She got the doors to the Christian, and said to her, "You are locked down, but I'll take your clothes to your mom." I take the homes to the Word of God, the Eucharist, the blessed throats, and place ashes on their heads. And the four homes that we do, we're going to see about 200 people a week. It's a challenge for people trying to stay awake while I'm preaching. We are people of love, laying on their hands to share their expressions and the kiss of peace. In prisons, I'm full of harsh questions, isolation. Why am I isolated? Thankfully, I hear the homes will be empty. We allow them to take meals and groups and have visitors inside the first time in 15 months. And the Ascension apostles spells out so that it is the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit did not discriminate in language. And the Holy Spirit held the apostles and proud them of being Christ in their native tongues. The Spirit did not discriminate by country, people, or languages. The Jews would not eat some food. But Paul had this conversation with the Spirit. Get up, Peter, and eat. Certainly not I. Nothing will pay or eat will ever enter my mouth. Voice from heaven answered, "What God has made clean, you are not a call of faith." Peter found out the Spirit did not come up for the Gentiles, the men, the women, for the kids. They were able to receive the Holy Spirit. Paul was in prison, on the street, when the jailer ran out, he tried to kill himself. Paul said, "No, let him know that he will not eat." The jailer invited him to have eaten this town, the whole matter received the Holy Spirit. The Spirit did not surrender it. This is an example the Spirit set for us, and if the world follows this example, it may not be so much so. Please do not be the Holy Spirit only the words of the African apostles. We heard in the gospel last week that it was not you who chose me, but I who chose you, and appointed you to go and bear fruit. Thank you.